Good evening, everyone. Welcome to our high school band concert tonight. I'm very excited to see all of you here. This is our grand finale of our Herricks concert season. It's a very special night, and this is a really special group of students you're going to hear to perform tonight. So thanks for sharing this evening with us. Before we start, we just have a couple of quick things. First, I'd like to recognize some people in the audience we have with us. First, we have Mr. Hodge, our assistant principal from Herricks High School. And we have Henry Zanetti from the Board of Education. I appreciate all of their support throughout all the years, and I would like to thank all of the parents in the audience for all your help making your students practice and encouraging them to love music. So let's give a round of applause for all the parents. I'd also like to recognize Ms. Lisa Rakowski, our Assistant Superintendent for Business. So before we start, you're in for a real treat tonight. This concert is going to be so enjoyable. I cannot wait to hear all the great music from our students. But before we do that, I'd like to encourage you to just take out your phone. Take out your phone. First of all, do you own the program? Everyone got the program? So take out your phone. I'd like you to download an app right now, if you can. Go onto your app finding place, whatever kind of phone you have, and I want you to look up Jingle Plus. Jingle Plus. J-I-N-G-L-E with a plus after it. And then download that. It's gonna come in handy later, so I would suggest you download it now, get it ready to go, and Mr. Stickley will let you know what you need to do. Okay. So, again, thank you for sharing this night with us. I wish you a very happy holiday season. We can't wait to hear for you to see you again at our future concerts in the spring and some in the winter. And I'm going to turn over the program to our band director, Scott Stickley. Thank you and enjoy the concert.
it seems a little interesting that your child just went to the high school, but they're back here at the middle school. Honey, what's... Anyway, actually, we're renovating our high school auditorium. It's in progress now. It should be done sometime in February. It's going to be amazing and beautiful. Have LED side lights. It's going to be quite wonderful. So we'll resume our concerts there. This particular band will have their concert in May. That was Kensington Overture. That particular piece is An Oldie But Goodie by Paul Weir. If you're watching The Crown, Kensington Palace is where I think William stays. It's one of the palaces in the Royal Rota. And Paul Weir wrote that back in 1978. So it's kind of an older piece. Really kind of gives that British feel. The next piece we'd like to play for you is kind of a freshman tradition of sorts. I've done it the last couple, 3 years. And Solitary Wish is written by Brian Balmages, who's one of the major writers for bands. And it's an interesting story, actually. He was going to like a local department store during the holidays, and he met a man who was homeless. And a lot of people were running by and walking by, and these program notes are actually in your program. But he finally stopped and talked to this man. He said, what's going on? He found out that this man was like just recently employed. He just was so close to the margins that he was now homeless. He had a wife and kids. And it really made Brian Balmages really think about, you know, people that maybe go without in the homeless situation or homeless reality that we have in our country. So he wrote this piece really to kind of remind everybody that we're all in this together. So this is a really wonderful work. It weaves two musical pieces together. One Child is Green Sleeves, and also Carol of the Bells. So you can hear them both kind of intertwined. And it's really wonderful. It has a little group at the end that plays. So I hope you enjoy Solitary Wish by Brian Balmages.
Thank you.
I saw a couple students from the past. I hope it's bringing back good memories for you. So anyway, so thank you so much. Isn't that intriguing? It's really beautiful. You just heard it kind of in and out. So this mic is really special. So I just said a couple of things. I really, really enjoy spending third period with this particular band. It's really wonderful. We're so eager. And we've had a really great year so far. And so we're really looking forward to the rest of the year. Sometimes we wonder what it is that we're learning in music education. Well, actually, what they're doing is actually making a lot of decisions about a lot of musical details. The reason why they sound like that is they're making musical decisions in musical detail and then applying their emotional lives to it. That hopefully it'll hit your lives. So that's kind of some of what's happening in music education. That's an amazing thing to develop. So anyway, the last piece we'd like to play is The Old Red Mill by Brian Carrick. It has a really beautiful opening. It's kind of like a countryside evoke. And then at the end, they're having kind of an old red mill dance at the end. Because I think if you had a big mill in the middle of your town, it's probably a place to come together. So we really want to thank you. If your son or daughter are in this group, we want to encourage you to stay for the rest of the show. It's really not that long. And there's a big party at the end if you download your Jingle Bell app. So anyway, and Old Red Mill, thank you.
Thank you.
So we're just gonna take, it's just gonna take a brief moment to do a bit of changeover. This is what I do between periods, by the way, if you wanna watch me work, actually. Thank you. many people played in band here? Great. How many people played in a string orchestra? Great. How many people sang in a chorus? Don't be shy. Great. How many people played in a starter rock and roll band? Yes! I love you. Anyway, it's so important to play music. So I just want to, first of all, thank you from the bottom of my heart for changing this date. I had my father, Frederick Marie Stickman, passed away at the age of 93 last summer. Yes, he is a wonderful man. I really miss him. And actually, this piece we're going to play now, when I was around with my sister and brother taking care of things, this particular melody of Samuel Houses, for whatever reason, stayed. And so I'd like to, it's actually called Yesterday's Joy. Solus Ane is actually Gaelic for Yesterday's Joy. And I think it's kind of a self-reflective piece of just realizing what a great past we had. And by realizing what a great past we have, we should have a great future too. So I hope you really enjoy it. It has this really wonderful opening, this wonderful chorale melody that sweeps underneath it. And on top is an Irish, like, penny whistle melody on top. You hear the flutes and high keys. And a very powerful new song that opens up. So I hope you really enjoy Solus Ane by Samuel Houses.
Thank you.
ensemble? I don't think so. Thank you. This is actually a group that meets in fourth period. They come moseying in from their other classes and spend time with me. And I have a wonderful time with them. It's just a great group, and we're going to play a couple selections for you before we have our jingle bell party. The next thing we'd like to play for you is something that all bands should play, and we play them, and this group is about to play, and that is a chorale. And a chorale is something that is actually an elongated melody. And typically chorales were from our sacred song or sacred piece, and in them you'll find this idea that we talk about in all the bands, which is the idea of consonant, dissonant, consonant, or major, minor, major. So this idea that, you know, major has this very hopeful sense to it, but then minor, there's a little bit of anguish. And a lot of times in chorales, the composer will go into this kind of minor area, and perhaps that's the person who's saying the prayer, really just really digging deep in their life to really find something, to really give them determination to win. So you really kind of hear this in this Faure chorale. He wrote this as a student, actually, in the late 19th century. So we hope you enjoy Gabriel's chorale by Gabriel Faure, excuse me.
Thank you.
Jackson and the other band, Prisha Agarwal and Sophie Chung, are actually all state musicians from the flute section. And we have actually some all-state musicians that went to all-state here in this particular band. Our bass clarinetist actually had a big major solo, and our flute player played first chair. She was the first chair flute player. Edwin played clarinet. Who else am I missing? Patrick Liu played the orchestra. Actually, typically, from a band program, you get one or two. For us to have four, actually six designated four goes, really amazing. And they all took great leadership roles. Can I ask you guys to stand for you guys? Oh, and Francisca Chung played English horn. Thank you so much. Carolyn Lau went to All Nationals at All National Report. How are we doing? We're good? You guys with me? We're still good? Everybody's good? Okay, we're almost done. Your Jingle Bell party has almost started. So, anyway, I'm going to feel so good when you Jingle Bell. I'm a man of stories. Just ask anybody that hangs with me in the office. It's like, I didn't get this point. Anyway. When I was a kid, I always got up and watched Saturday morning cartoons. How many people watch Saturday morning cartoons? Bugs Bunny, remember Bugs Bunny, right? Yeah, amazing, right? And you know, the interesting thing, Bugs Bunny, Tom and Jerry, all those cartoons actually had amazing music. And the music was written by actually serious composers. From like they were composers that studied in the 40s and 50s, but they lived in Los Angeles, they needed to make some money, and they started to write for cartoons. So if you really listen to that Bugs Bunny music, one particular composer, I think I just mentioned, Carl Stallings was somebody. It's amazing music. It's serious music that's set to these wonderful cartoons. And fast forward, Vincent Apido is a composer, now lives in LA. In fact, Steven Spielberg wants him to write a movie film score for him. But before he did that, he went to East Middle High School, and he's a Long Island's own, and he wrote this piece, Il Mazzamorello, which is about a little Italian elf that comes into your home and kind of raises havoc. So you can kind of hear all this little back and forth, and he comes into your home and he races through and maybe steals a crumb or two and gets a cookie and then leaves and goes to another home. He's kind of going in and out. At the end, he marches off into the sunset. So we hope you enjoy Vincent Apido's Il Mazzamorello, the mystical Italian elf. So thank you so much. We're right on schedule. Thank you so much for taking time out. You know, I have a sophomore in high school, and she's in a music program. And when there's a concert night, it's like the whole domestic is all. So thank you so much for coming out tonight. I hope you really enjoyed. Did you enjoy your cartoon chase? So I want to thank everybody who helped today, Nana Mori and Alexis Camisa, and also my dear friend Catherine Burke, all helped from behind the scenes to help. Now, how many people downloaded their app? Anybody got it? So you can just jingle, jingle, jingle. There's lots of jingle bells back there. There's four sets. We're going to play Sleigh Ride. It's a Parrots tradition that predates me by a lot of years, but it's always a lot of fun. This is our last holiday concert, so I hope you take good care in the coming storm and have a wonderful, rich holiday as we celebrate this season. Thank you so much. Jingle, ready? Jing, 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 jing. There you go, that's it.